AI Builder is the part of the Power Platform that allows you to bring artificial intelligence into your Power Apps and into your workflows. No code. It's a wizard-style interface. Super easy to use. Let me take you through it in 5 minutes. There are two types of models that you get in the AI Builder. One of them is a model that you can train yourself. So you feed this with your own data. The other type is pre-built models. These ones are provided for you. This is basically a click and point, grab and go. You don't do any kind of training on the model at all. You use them as they are. So first, let's run through these five custom models. The form processing model is great for working with paper-based forms or image-based forms. So they can come in a photo or a PDF kind of format. Let's say you get invoices coming into your organization, or you want to have them come in by email, grab the data off them and put that into a database somewhere. That's exactly what the form processing model can do. The object detection model is about being able to recognize and count objects in images. Because it's a custom model, you train it with your own images. So whatever you train it to recognize is what it's able to recognize. The prediction model is all about looking at your historical data and using that to predict future outcomes. The prediction model can handle binary prediction, yes, no, is someone likely to renew their membership? It can handle multiple options. Is the shipment going to be early, on time, or delayed? And it can also handle a numerical outcome. How much is this claim going to be worth? There's great power in this one, especially if you've got a rich data set going on in Dataverse or Dynamics 365. The category classification custom model learns to read blocks of texts, perfect for like incoming reviews, incoming emails, social media posts, that sort of thing, and classify them according to categories that you've set up. This is much more sophisticated than just searching for keywords. It actually learns from your training data set how you want things to be categorized. Awesome use for things like routing in a customer service scenario so that the incoming things can just go straight to the right team. Our last one here is the entity extraction model. This is all about extracting known pieces of information, which is how the word entity is being used here, from unstructured text, things like colors or your own terminology. Then you want to be able to pick out those specific bits of information from the text. So not just general keywords, but the particular things that you're looking for. So now let's have a look at the pre-built models. Microsoft has done all the training of the models and you can just use them in your apps and workflows. Category classification. This one is pre-built for you with categories that are ready to go for a pretty typical customer service scenario. So if you're working in an environment where that will work for you, you can just grab and go with this one. With entity extraction, these are the standard things that you can get with the standard model that you don't need to train. So you'll see here, it's able to pick things out of the text like percentages, names, ages, colors, and so on. Key phrase extraction, pretty much what it says on the box. It will go through your text and it will extract the keywords. And then you can take that and put that, say, in a text field, a list of the key phrases. Language detection identifies what language the text is. Sentiment analysis is about identifying the sentiment in your text. You'll get an overall positive, neutral, or negative, as well as the percentage likelihood of the accuracy on those things. And it can also go down to sentence level. Business card reader. You can read a business card and it will take the information from the business card. You can put that into your CRM system or wherever else you need it. Text recognition will recognize text in images. So if you want to take a photo of something and get the text read from that, that's what this one can do. We have a receipt processing model, which will go through and take all of the information from the receipt. So you can use this to create your own expense apps, and similarly an invoice processing model. So very similar to the form builder, but these ones are pre-built ready to go to do receipts and invoices. You'll find AI Builder at make.powerapps.com and here it is on the menu. To get started, all you need to do is go into models here, click Builder Model, select the model that you want to work with, give it a name and click create. From there, you'll find yourself in a wizard style interface and it's just a matter of following the steps for that particular model down the side. If you're doing something like this with text, it'll ask you to match it up to where your training data is. If you're doing something with images, it'll ask you to upload and tag your images and so on. From there, you can start using it in your apps and flows. You'll find it in Canvas apps. There's an AI Builder menu at the top there and you can just grab those models and start using them in your apps. And in Flow, you'll find it here in the predict action. You'll get a list of all of the pre-built models as well as any custom models that you've built, and you can start using those to automate your business processes using AI. I hope that's been helpful. Thanks for watching.